park in Colorado, so it might be a little noisy, but see these lovely mountains behind me. It's gonna be a super short 30-minute Hatha style flow. So we're going to kind of slow it down. I have a lot of fast pace flows, so if you really want a fast pace flow, you can find one on my Patreon. This, for 30 minutes, we're gonna start to slow it down and focus on our breath work, and it's gonna tie into the whole full moon and just coming back to our bodies, all of that. So let's go ahead and get started. We're gonna start with butterfly pose. So coming in a nice tall seated position with the soles of the feet together, spine nice and long and strong, and let yourself just kind of breathe here into the space. Maybe close your eyes if you like to, or just let yourself breathe into it. We're gonna start with three deep breaths. When you're ready, big inhale, breathing in through the belly for 3, 2, 1, and exhale out, 3, 2, 1. Again, just like that, deep into the belly, breathe in for 3, 2, 1, and exhale out for 3, 2, 1. One more time, nice, slow, and controlled. Deep breath in for 3, 2, 1, and deep breath out, 3, 2, 1. Let yourself breathe here, maybe pausing into the space for just a moment. If you want a little bit more into your butterfly, lift up through the heart and hinge forward. Maybe slowly bringing the palms down in front, pausing here. If you have even more, feel free to go a little bit deeper wherever you're at. In Hatha, we hold poses and breathe deep into them for about 4 or 5 rounds of breath. Inhaling, we'll slowly roll back up. Long spine, lift the chin, open up the throat. Exhale, chin towards the chest, back of the neck, breathe. One more like that. Inhale, lift the chin, open out the throat. Exhale, chin towards the chest, back into the neck, breathe here. Option to stay or slowly let the head rock over to one shoulder. Maybe breathe here into the side of the neck. Feel that stretch. Again, option to stay here. Just get a little movement, rolling back and forth. Or all the way around. Just find your nice deep belly breaths into that center here.
Be by your side.
rest and how we'll slowly roll up. Beautiful. Bring the right knee bent in. However is comfortable. Left leg, will cross over the right. So bent here. Big inhale, lift the arms. And exhale, twist over towards the left side, maybe hooking that right elbow or just hugging the right knee in. Look over the left shoulder. Reach both arms up. Straighten both legs out in front now. Seated forward fold, really flex those toes, reach nice and tall. And then exhale, bow forward. This time your left leg is going to bend down in the front and the right leg will cross over with the knee stay bent. And same thing, big inhale, we'll reach tall. Exhale, twist to the right this side, either hooking or hugging. Looking over that right shoulder, breathe deep here. And go ahead and take them behind you, palms to the front, coming to that tabletop position first. If you want to get a little more movement, you're kind of cheating the Hatha style, but feel free to flow through your cat and cows. Inhale, pressing the belly down, lifting up through the heart. And exhale, rounding the spine. And just get a little movement as that feels good. You can again hold these poses if you prefer, or keep moving back and forth between the two. Next, inhale, lift that right leg up. Option to bend the knee, open up the hip. Again, hold here for deep breath. Comes down, toes turn out, big inhale, lift it up, warrior one, hold it strong, feel that nice and bent knee, hold that spine nice and long, and breathe. Beautiful. gonna find that transition to warrior three, option to keep the palms up or to the heart. Your choice, lift tall and lift. Lengthen out that body. Body is in a T shape, really pulling that heart forward, belly down, flexing that back foot. You can do it, hold strong. Try to focus your gaze to help your breath and just breathe here a few more breaths. Beautiful. Slowly bring the fingertips towards the hips. Use this core to step that left foot behind you a little more narrower of a stance. Both toes are forward. Lift up to the heart. For this pose, we're going to keep that back really nice and strong. So inhale, breathe forward, pull that heart forward, and find that flat back and just breathe here. Keep the fingertips towards the hips, or if you want to grab opposite elbows behind, you can. Your choice. Spine is nice forward, gaze is just a few feet in front of the toes. Release fingertips down. Bend the front knee, shift the weight forward. Step that back foot further back behind you and go ahead, drop the knee. Low lunge, untuck the toes. And inhale, lift and breathe. If you're feeling tired, you can always bring the palms to the knee and press open. Hold. From here, big inhale, you're going to start to tuck the back toes. Gauge the core, inhale, lift the back knee and turn that back foot out, warrior two. So adjust yourself as you need to, arms will come out, gaze over the right fingertips. Breathe here. We're going to start to come to extended side angle. Slowly bring the right forearm down to the right thigh. Left arm above the ear. I know the leg is tired. Just breathe into your right. Hold here. For peak pose, if you want to start working on that lower extended side angle, slowly work the palm down in front. We like it in front here. So remember, we're not dumping all our weight to the palm. We're keeping it strong in our legs. Again, stay here. Start to wrap that right arm underneath the right thigh and left arm behind the back. Hold here. This can be your peak or just reaching toward it or holding it here. Now, if you want that bird of paradise peak pose, bend the back leg, slowly step it forward. Ow. Now slowly begin to come onto the tippy toes of the right. The knee will stay bent first. Keep those palms linked and lift up to that light right leg. And again, maybe nice and strong, straighten. Hold for as long as you can, breathe deep. Woo, four, three, two, and one, wherever you're at, slowly release down. Turn yourself towards the front of the mat, walk those feet out 45 degrees, and sink it down to your malasana. Use those elbows to press the knees open. Just breathe here. You did it. Great job. Take a few breaths. If malasana is uncomfortable for you, feel free to just go ahead and come back to child's pose. We're just going to take a rest. Beautiful. When you're ready, palms will come down. And we'll slowly step it back to downward facing dog or child's pose if you need a breath. Hold it here wherever you're at.
next inhale, nice and strong. Lift the left leg up. Option to again bend that knee, open out the hip, hold it here, breathe deep. Inhale, find that left knee in towards the chest, stepping up for your warrior one. Right heel comes down, toes out. Inhale, lift. Warrior one, hold. To that warrior three. Next, arms stay lifted, or you can bring them to the heart, your choice. Hold it strong, lift that back leg up. Ah! Pull that chest down. Find your balance wherever you're at. Try to pull that body nice and long. You can do it. Flex that back foot and hold. Gaze is in front. Fix it on something that is not moving. Fingertips slowly begin to come to the hips. Nice and strong, controlled. Use that core, bring the right toes down. Slightly closer stance, both toes are still forward. Inhale, lift up through the heart. And then again, flat back. Pulling those fingertips to make sure those hips stay in line. And then option again, stay here, wrap the arms behind the back, opposite elbows. Keep the gaze a few feet in front of the toes to keep the spine long. Slowly bring those fingertips down. And again, start to bend the front left leg, dropping the right leg further back. Low lunge, take your time to get there, dropping the right knee down, untucking the toes. Walk the palms up. Maybe stay here or lift all the way. Alright, last few transitions. We're coming up to that warrior two. So back toes tucked. Inhale, lift the back leg up and then open out. Turning that back heel parallel, arms open out to a T. Adjust your stance if you need to. Strong warrior two, gaze over the left fingertips, hold here. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been faking me out. Beautiful. Start to slowly find extended side angle on this side. Bringing the left forearm down to the left side, right arm over the ear. Hold it strong. Breathe here. Ah! And I fall forward. Okay. Stay here again. Or if you want to work on that full extended side angle, left palm is down. Breathe here. Again, maybe this is your peak. Maybe you stay here. Maybe you want that bind. Bringing that left arm around. Right arm behind. This can be a peak, beautiful. If you want to come into that bird of paradise, bend the back knee, step it forward. Slowly, slowly, slowly begin to lift it up. Keep it slow and begin to straighten. If you want more, hold here. Come forward again one more time. Vinyasa, toes turn out and bend it down. Beautiful. Let yourself breathe here. thumbs will come down. Step it back, downward dog, and then we'll all go ahead and drop our knees wide to a child's pose. Release all the way down and let yourself find a few breaths here. Inhale, we'll slowly lift up to the heart. Palms come down. Top the toes, step back. Downward dog or child's pose. You choose. Hold here. Coming to downward dog, we'll lift the left foot up, keep it straight, hold it strong, few breaths. Exhale, slowly bring that left leg in, lay the shin down. Set up your pigeon on this side again. Pressing open through the heart, lifting up, creating some space for you so that when you come forward, you have a little more room. And exhale, release down. Slowly walk it back up. Again, palms down, step back. Downward dog or child's pose. Last time, breathe here. To slowly step the feet forward, crossing at the ankles so we can sit the hips down.
go ahead, bring both feet straight out in front. One more time, flexing those toes. Bring your weight onto the sit bones. Big inhale, lift. Exhale, release, forward fold. Pull that belly down. See if you can go a little bit deeper than the beginning of class, or just till you feel that stretch. Again, just breathing for yourself. Inhale, roll up. Bending the knees, make sure you have some space behind you. Start to rock it back to our backs, rolling it out a few times if that feels good. Meeting me on your backs, bring the right leg and left leg long in front. And take the twist, right leg to the left side, let your right arm come out, let the gaze follow. Bring that knee in. One more deep hug and then switch it out, bringing the left leg and right leg long in front. Pull that knee in towards the chest. Again, option to stay here or slowly take it over to the right side. Gaze falls towards the left, palm out. Next, inhale, slowly bring both knees in towards the chest. Go ahead and find your last pose, a happy baby or a bridge or whatever else you need here. Just find a nice, slow, deep stretches, anything that feels good before we start to set up for Shavasana. When you're ready, just slowly straighten the legs out in front of you, bringing one palm to your belly, one palm to your heart, releasing all the breath out. And deep inhale, we'll breathe into the belly for 3, 2, 1. At the very top, open the mouth and sigh it all out. Again, just like that, deep breath into the belly. Start to breathe and breathing it in nice and deep for 3, 2, 1. At the very top, open the mouth, sigh it out.
your tension, all your stress, start to breathe it in for 3, 2, 1, more breath in. At the very top, exhale, release it out. Let the arms open out and stay here in your body, is breathing deep just a few moments. Gently, wherever you're at, just in your body, slowly begin to wiggle your fingers or your toes, maybe rolling your wrists or your ankles out. Inhaling, draw your knees in towards your chest, giving them a loving hug. Exhaling, rock over to your favorite side, pausing here for a moment of gratitude, for a moment of thanks for coming here, showing up on your mat virtually with me. Whenever you're ready, gently press yourself up to any comfortable seated position that works for you. Taking a deep breath in, we'll inhale, sweep the arms up, bringing palms together into Anjali Mudra. Exhale, lower Anjali Mudra to the third eye, to always trust your intuition, your inner knowing. Lower Anjali Mudra to your mouth so that your words may mirror your actions. And bring Anjali Mudra to the heart to always have kind and pure intentions. Thank you so much for your presence today. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Namaste. Right, hopefully it wasn't too noisy around here, but it's gorgeous scenery, so get to enjoy that. Hope you have a great time. Let me know what you thought about this power Hatha flow. And yeah, I'll see you next time on your mat.